हेलो माय डियर लवली स्टूडेंट, वेलकम वन सेकेंड टू माय इंग्लिश क्लास। आई थिंक यू आर गुड इन योर होम। ओके, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट समथिंग न्यू।
टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट सम इंग्लिश ग्रामर। फर्स्ट लुक सम पिक्चर्स। नाउ टेल मी व्हाट इज द बैट्समैन डूइंग इन दिस पिक्चर। Yes, the batsman is playing. Okay, the batsman is playing. Now, look the second picture. What is the children doing? What is the children doing in this image? The children are writing. The children are writing in this image. Now, look the third picture. What is the man doing in this image? What is the man doing in this image? The man is running. The man is running. Here, playing, running, and writing are the action words. Here, playing, running, writing are the action word. Now tell me, what are they? Now they are verbs. They are verbs. So today, we will discuss about verbs. ओके, व्हाट इज वर्ब? नाउ टेल मी व्हाट इज वर्ब? ए वर्ब इज अ वर्ड दैट एक्सप्रेस एन एक्शन और अकुरेंस और स्टेट ऑफ बीइंग। ओके, तले वर्ब इज अ वर्ड दैट एक्सप्रेशन एन एक्शन अकुरेंस और स्टेट ऑफ बीइंग। सम अदर सेज व्हाट ए सब्जेक्ट डज इज वर्ब। सम अदर सेज What a subject does is verb. We cannot make a sentence without a verb. Okay, no sentence can be completed without a verb, because verb is the main part of a sentence. Verb is the main part of a sentence. A vehicle cannot move without an engine. A vehicle cannot move without an engine. So like verb, we cannot make a sentence without verb. Okay, so we cannot make a sentence without a verb. So verb is the main part of a sentence. Now verb tells us the two things about the subject. Verb tells us the two things about the subject. Verb, first action or state of being. Action or activity performed by the subject. So action or activity performed by the subject. The state of being verbs, state or situation of the subject. State or situation of the subject. Let me give you some example of an action verb. Look very carefully. Look at, tell me, what do you see in this image? The girl is dancing. The girl is dancing. Now tell me, what is this girl doing? What is this girl doing? The girl is dancing. It's dancing. So dance is an action verb. So dance is an action verb. Now look in this image. What do you see in this image? Children are playing. Children are playing. Then what is the perform doing by the children? What is the perform doing by the children? It's playing. It is playing. So playing is an action word. Playing is an action word. Now let look at state of being verbs. Now look at the state being of verbs. Look, what is this? He is a boy. We says Ram is a boy. So is, here is state verb, as it define the state whether he is a boy or a girl. Look this picture. In this image the boy feels very tired. In this image the boy feels very tired. So feels here is the state verb. you define the subject of the boy. Okay, you define the state of the boy. Now, let's look into some sentence example of them. First, let's see the action verbs. Children are playing. Children are playing. Here, what is the action performed by the children? What is the action performed by the children? It is playing. So, playing is an action verb. So, playing is an action verb. So, see, the girls are dancing. The girls are dancing. What is the perform doing by the girl? What is the perform doing by the girls? It's dancing. So, dancing is an action verb. So, dancing is an action verb. Now, let's look into the state verbs. They define the state or situation of subject. They define the state or situation of subjects. First, she feels happy. She feels happy. Here, what is the state of the girl? What is the state of the girl? Now, it's feeling happy. It's feeling happy. So, feels is a state verb. So, feels is a state verb. I am a boy. I am a boy. Here, how do we define whether he is a boy or a girl? How do we define whether he is a boy or a girl? So, am is state verb here. So, am is the state verb here. Now look, they are farmers. They are farmers. Here, the state of the persons are that they are farmers. They are farmers. So, here are used as the state verb. So, here are used as the state verb. So, remember, verb tells about the action or state of subject. So, verb tells about the action or state of subject. Now, look, verb are mainly divided into two parts. Verb are mainly divided into two parts. Main verb and auxiliary verb. Main verb and auxiliary verb. We can also say main verb as full verb and auxiliary verb also says helping verb. Now, discuss about main verb. So, now tell me, what are the main verbs? What are the main verbs? The main verbs are the words that actually show the action or activity of subject. Once again, main verb are the words that actually show the action or activity of subject. The main verb shows the activity of subject. They can stand alone. They can stand alone without the help of any other verbs. Okay, so they can stand alone without the help of any other verbs. Now, example of them are read, sleep, eat, play, run, fly. All these verbs can exist independently and provides complete meaning of sentence. Okay, all these verbs can exist independently and provide complete meaning of sentence. Let me give you some sentence example of them. Children play. Children play. Here, what are the activity of the children? Here, what are the activity of the children? It is playing. So, playing is the main verb here. Birds fly in the sky. Here, what is the activity or performed doing by the birds? What is the activity or performed doing the birds? It is flying. So here, flying is the main verb. So flying is the main verb here. Students write. Students writes. Here, what is the activity doing by the students? What is the activity doing by the students? It is writing. It is writing. So here, write is the main verb here. Here, write is the main verb. Now, let's see the auxiliary verb or helping verbs. Let's see the auxiliary verb or the main verbs. They gives more meaning to the main verb. They give more meaning to the main verb. They cannot stand alone. They cannot stand alone. That means they requiring main verb for their existence. They cannot stand alone. That means they requiring main verb for their existence. So mane nije bakya tiyari kari paribe nahi. Main verb sangere rahi bakya tiyari kari paribe. Or they help main verb. Examples of them are is, has, do, did. These are referred to as the main helping verb. And will, shall, can, may, could, would, might, must. These are called modal auxiliary. These are called modal auxiliary. Will, shall, can, may, could, would, might, must. These are called modal auxiliary. Let me give you some sentence examples to make you clear about them. For the first example is Sita is. Can you understand what the sentence is saying about Sita? Can you understand what the sentence is saying about Sita? Sita is what? Now, look at the complete sentence. Sita is singing. Sita is singing. Here, it is giving the complete meaning. It is giving the complete meaning. So, here is the helping verb. And singing is the main verb. Okay. Now, look the second example. Ratan will. Ratan will what? Can you understand what the sentence is saying about Ratan? Ratan is what? Now, look at the complete sentence. Ratan will go to Katak. Ratan will go to Katak. Here, we have used go, which is the main verb, and will is the helping verb here. Okay, now, you all understood the main verb and auxiliary verb. Now, we will do some exercises. Find out the auxiliary verb and find out the main verb. You write auxiliary verb, short form AB, and main verb MB. Okay. Now, look. She has made a house. Cows are grazing in the field. You were looking for good job. I am going to have a son. She could not dance. Children are playing in the field. Here, she has made a house. Now find out the main verb and auxiliary verb. Here, has is the auxiliary verb and made is the main verb. Cows are grazing in the field. Are is the auxiliary verb and grazing is the main verb. You were looking for a good job. Where is the auxiliary verb and looking is the main verb. I am going to have a son. Here am is the auxiliary verb and going is the main verb. She could not dance. Could is the auxiliary verb and dance is the main verb. Children are playing in the field. Here are is the auxiliary verb and playing is the main verb. Okay, understand?
Now we discuss about another classification of verbs like finite verb and non-finite verbs. What is finite verb? Finite verb is a verb which carries the tense of a sentence. The finite verb is a verb which carry the tense of a sentence. Finite verb will change as per the tense of the sentence, as per the number of the subject, and as per the person of the subject. Now, look some sentence example. They play football every day. They played football yesterday. The first sentence is in present tense and the second sentence is in past tense. How do you know the first sentence is present tense and the second sentence is past tense? How do you know? To look the verb play and played. Play is the first form, the present form of the verb, and played is the past form of the verb. So here play and played at the finite verb. In the first sentence play change into played in the second sentence. Then here the play change into played as per the tense. Now look more. Boy is playing. Boys are playing. Here is change into are, because in the first sentence the subject is singular and in the second sentence the subject is plural. So is change into are. Tale is or are the finite verb here. Now look. I go to school. He goes to school. In the first sentence go, in the second sentence change into goes, because in the first sentence the subject is first person singular and in the second sentence he is the third person singular number. So go change into goes. Tell here go change into goes because as per the person, as per the person of the subject. Now look, what is non-finite verb? Tell me, what is non-finite verb? Non-finite verb is a verb which does not carry the tense. Tale non-finite verb is a verb which does not carry the tense. And also, it does not change as per the tense, person, and number of the subject. Non-finite verb do not have any agreement with the subject. Also, non-finite verb do not have any agreement with the subject. Subject sahita tar kichhi samparka na thai. Now, look some sentence example. I like to play tennis. He likes to play tennis. Children want to eat sweets. Rasmita wants to eat sweets. Look, the first two sentences, these are in present tense. How do you know these are in present tense? Now, like and likes tells us that these are in present tense. Now look, the first like change into likes in the second sentence, because their subject I change into he. So like change into likes, but there are another verb play do not change. Another verb do play do not change. So here play is a non-finite verb.
So play is a non-finite verb here because it does not change as per the tense, as per the subject, or as per the number of the person. Now look the last two sentences. Children want to eat sweets. Rasmita wants to eat sweets. Here want change into wants. These are the finite verb because they carry the tense. But eat does not carry the tense, so it is a non-finite verb. Okay, because it does not change as per the subject, as per the tense, or as per the person of the subject. Now look more sentence. He sang sitting on a chair. They talk sitting on the bed. Here sitting is same in both sentences. So sitting is a non-finite verb because it does not change as per the tense, as per the number of the subject, or as per the person of the subject. In the first sentence, subject is he. In the second sentence, subject is they. He is the third person singular number, and they is the third person plural number. Now, you all understood finite verb and non-finite verb. Now, we talk another classification of verbs, strong verb and weak verb. Now tell me, what is strong verb? The verb having the same form in all tense is strong verb. The verb having the same form in all tense is strong verb. Like, look some examples. Like read, read, read. Spread, spread, spread. Cut, cut, cut. Put, put, put. Now, what is weak verb? What is weak verb? The verb having different form in different tenses is the weak verb. Okay, once again, the verb having different form in different tenses is the weak verb. Now, look some example. Go, went, gone. Break, broke, broken. Sing, sang, sung. Now, look some sentence example. We read newspaper every day. They read yesterday. I will read the book. In the first sentence is in present, second sentence is in past, the third sentence is in present. But the read, the verb read, do not change in three sentences. So here read is the strong verb here. Now look, Rohan went to school. Ram goes to school. He had gone to Puri. Here first sentence is in past, second sentence is in present, third sentence is in past tense. First sentence went, second sentence goes, and third sentence gone. Change into go, change into goes, change into went, and change into gone as per the tense. So here go is the weak verb because it changes. Okay, you all understood the verbs. Main verb, auxiliary verbs, strong verb, weak verbs, finite verb, non-finite verbs. Okay. Now, do all the exercises that will be given.
See you. Thank you.